Quickly in your Bibles to the book of Acts, chapter number 23. Acts chapter number 23. Amen. Just trust in the Lord to help us. I'm going to look at verse number 11. Acts 23, verse number 11. Amen. We find that the Apostle Paul is preaching the gospel. And it's discouraging for him. He's in Jerusalem, Brother Eli, and it's just discouraging. People aren't accepting the gospel, Sister Dietrich. He's doing what he knows is right. And the Bible says there in this discouraging time, he said, and the night following, the Lord stood by him and said, "Be of good cheer, Paul, for as you testified of me in Jerusalem, so must you bear witness also at Rome." Praise God. I this evening want to look at this encouragement that is needed in times of our life. Amen. But there's four different elements that I want to look at in this situation. The Apostle Paul, he's very discouraged, and in the situation that he's in, he is in bounds and in custody of Roman soldiers in a fortress. He had been falsely accused, and it looks like evil has won. And it almost seems as though his ministry for the kingdom of God is over, but God's about to change things. When it comes to our darkest hour, it seems like God then gives the most encouraging words. Amen. When it comes to our darkest hour, it seems like God knows how to give the most encouraging words. Maybe you're not going through a dark hour. It's all right. I think there's some things I want to share with you that I noticed about this verse this evening that are so integral about staying encouraged. The Bible says that David encouraged himself in the Lord. Sister Barbara, sometimes we have to do that. Just encourage ourselves in the Lord. Folks will come, folks will go. Sister Tina, I've been saved long enough. I've seen a lot of people pass through this church. I see a lot of people pass through, Brother Justin, my life and change their direction. But one thing for sure is my relationship with God, I've got to encourage myself and I've got to see a move of God. Right. And so I want to look at four things. The very first thing is this. The Bible says that the Lord stood by him. One of the most encouraging things that we need in our life is the presence of God. Amen. I feel God at home. I feel God in my devotions. I feel God in my quiet time. Sometimes in my driving. I don't use the phone. I don't turn the radio on, Brother Doug. I just spend my time praying and make best use of that time that I can. And so those moments are all good. We need the presence of God. We need to practice God's presence in our life. Amen. So the presence of God is the very first thing. Nothing in this world will encourage you as the presence of God will encourage you. Amen. Not many at all were standing with Paul. Amen. When everybody else forsakes us, then the Lord knows how to take us up. The Word of God says, when thy mother and thy father forsake thee, then the Lord will take us up. God knows what he's doing. Amen. He knows how to encourage. He knows how to visit right on time every time.
Amen.
And so the presence of God. Amen. One of the things that I think is quite interesting about the presence of God, you want to stay encouraged. I believe that the presence of God is the ticket for staying encouraged. You'll find that when Moses was leading the nation of Israel, you'll find that there in Exodus chapter number 33, we find that there is the tabernacle, Sister Tina, that's there. The glory of God is a pillar. Moses is there at the tabernacle. Sister Dietrich, the Bible says that presence of God come down and begin to dwell and commune with Moses, Brother Justin. And the Bible says that they talked as friend to friend. face to face. There they were. They were talking to one another. And I love what verse number 15 says in Exodus chapter number 33. The Bible says, "And he," or Moses, "said unto him," the Lord, "if your presence goes, go not with me, carry us not up from thence." Moses said something. "God, if you're not going to go with me, I don't want to go there. God, if there's anything that keeps me encouraged in my life and helps me in my life and sustains me in my life, it is your presence." Amen. Being able to get in that place where friend with friend we talk to the Lord. Amen. And we tell Him, "God, if you move, I'll move. But if you're staying here, I'm not going. I need to go where your presence is." Amen. How do we stay encouraged? By the presence of God. Amen. Here it is. Paul, the Bible says that the Lord stood by him, the presence of God. Some would say that this is a Christophany. Amen. This isn't the first time. Go back to the previous chapter. You'll find that on the road to Damascus that Jesus Christ appeared to Paul. Going into Corinthians, you'll find that there are other manifestations of the Lord to Paul. Amen. It's the presence of God that will sustain and keep and encourage us. When you feel discouraged, what are you going to do? Amen. I don't believe eating a big box of chocolates to do it. Amen. That makes your taste buds feel good for a while. Now, I don't think that there's a lot of things in this world that will do it. The only thing that will encourage us is the presence of God. Genesis chapter number 39. Turn there. Genesis chapter number 39 and verse number 21. We find that Joseph is in prison. He's been betrayed by Potiphar's wife. He's there in prison. He's been betrayed by his brothers. And we talk about a life of loneliness and betrayal, trying to be faithful to God. The Word of God says in verse number 21, "But the Lord was with Joseph. And showed him mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison." What will keep us in our most discouraging times, Brother David? Amen. The Lord visiting with us. Amen. Allowing Him to come in to our hearts and our minds and our souls and just begin to minister and touch us. Amen. Here it is that the Word of God says that the Lord stood by Paul. You're discouraged, Paul. The presence of God will encourage you. Amen. You can endure difficulty because God is with you. It doesn't matter who stands against you. The only important thing is knowing that the Lord stands with you. Seek His abiding presence in your life. Amen. The hours that are dark, the hours that are discouraging, and the Lord stood by him. The Bible says, and he said, "Be of good cheer." If I could say it this way, Sister Tina, when God spoke and he said to him, "Be of good cheer." You ever have someone, Sister Barbara, you're feeling down and out, maybe they pat you on the back, or Brother Doug, they give you a little bump on the arm, and they say, "Cheer up, man. Cheer up. It'll be all right." You know what they're doing? They're kind of giving you a little bit of a command, aren't they? They're telling you what to do. Amen. Here it is. God speaks and he says, "Be of good cheer." Amen. It's encouraging tonight to know that encouragement comes from the precepts of God's Word as well as the promises of God's Word. You may say, "Well, what are the precepts, Brother Saville?" You're saying precepts and promises. We love the promises of God's Word. If I ask you tonight what's your favorite verse, you're probably going to give me a verse that tells me about the promises of God. Amen. But Brother David, what are the precepts of God? It's this. It is a principle or a rule that is used to control or influence or regulate our conduct. These precepts are like the Ten Commandments. They're given to us, Brother Dennis, they're commandments that we are to do. And God, when he speaks them to us, amen, it will encourage us. What did he do? Sister Barbara didn't command Pat Paul in the back to just say, be of good cheer, but he commanded him, be of good cheer. Amen. It's choice. And I want you to choose right now. Joy. I want you to get your eyes off the situations that you're in right now, Brother David. And I want you to be of good cheer. Commandments are avenues of blessing when we cheerfully do what God has asked us to do, even when it's in dark times. I say, but Saville, it seems like dark times, or it's discouraging times, or the situation's a little overwhelming. Let me ask you something. Have you been standing on the precepts of God? Amen. Thank God for His promises. But are you doing what God has commanded and asked you to do? Because if you have, amen, there's something about the presence of God, but there's something about the precepts of God. When God says, do what I command you to do, then you'll find that there's strength and encouragement in it. Mm-hmm. And why so many don't have joy in their life? Because they've never found the precepts of God to work. Paul could have been here, and I know the Word of God didn't say that he was there pouting or complaining. But one thing that is for sure is that Paul was going through some discouraging times. And as he's going through these discouraging times, God speaks to him and says, be of good cheer. Be of good cheer. Sister Dietrich, I love what Paul writes a little later in the book of Philippians. Brother Justin, he is in prison when he writes this. And Paul writes and he says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Brother Eli, we probably have quoted that a million times, but let's think about it for a minute. Sister Beth, what's he saying? Rejoice in the Lord always. Amen. Not for all things, but in all things. I don't have to like being sick. I don't have to like the loss of a loved one. I don't have to like when things go wrong and folks are against me. I don't have to like it. But one thing that God does require of me is to rejoice in Him in my present situation. Amen. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Amen. Paul is talking about something that's important. We read, we study, we hear about tending to the emotional well-being of people. Paul was talking about the emotional well-being of folks. He said, you want to be emotionally well and emotionally happy? Rejoice in the Lord always. It will do something for your psyche. It'll do something for your emotions. Rejoice in the Lord always. So the precepts from God's Word, don't stop. The presence of God will encourage us. And the precepts from God will encourage us when we are doing what God has said. One thing, Sister Beth, sometimes I just have to stand and say, I've done what I know God wants me to do. And so the joy of the Lord is knowing that I can rejoice. Because, Sister Dietrich, I've done what God asked. Be of good cheer. The third thing that he says, thou hast testified of me in Jerusalem. The praise from God. Thou hast testified of me in Jerusalem. There are some times we may look at our life and we may say, wow, I've been a real failure there. I didn't see the outcome. I didn't see the interest. I didn't see the return that I wanted on that. Listen, God is not asking you to calculate things. God is asking you to be faithful. Because our calculations can most oftentimes, if not always, be wrong. But God calculates things right. Amen. And he looks at Paul and he says this. He says, you have testified of me in Jerusalem. God gives Paul this pat on the back. He said, you've been doing well. I want you to keep on doing well. Listen, men might be speaking evil of you, amen, but I want you to know that I am thankful and appreciative for what you have done. Sometimes we just need to get in a place where God says to us, you've been faithful with what I've given to you. And so God gives us a little pat on the back. You've been faithful in your life, and you've been faithful with your time. You've been faithful with your resources. You've been faithful with your finances. You've been faithful with your family. You've been faithful with the church. Amen. Don't look at it as man's perspective. Amen. But hear what God says. When we begin to think, oh, what will man say? Man looks at this and he evaluates it, and it's less than par. But God says, my evaluation isn't that, because I've asked you to be faithful. Joseph, it doesn't matter if you're in prison. It doesn't matter what Potiphar's wife did. You've been faithful with the dream and the vision that I've given you. And the vision will come to pass. It will speak and it will not lie. So Joseph, well done. Daniel, well done, Daniel. Even the most difficulty of being thrown into the lions, and you've done well. Job, you've done well. David, even though you've fallen miserably, but I see your heart and the repentant heart. You've done well.
Amen.
Amen. Praise from God. Amen. Get in the Word of God. Let God's Word encourage you. God's faithful. Yeah. So the things that we've looked at tonight, the Lord stood by him. The presence of God. Be of good cheer. The precepts of God. The commands to Barbara that God gave him. The praise from God, where he says, thou hast tested. You did what I wanted you to do. God gives him a pat on the back. And then the fourth and the final thing that I want to look at is here. So must thou bear witness also at Rome. The promise of God. See, Paul's really discouraged because he's bound. He's in an army fortress. Who knows what's going to happen? But God spoke and he said, but I'm not done, Paul. My promise is you're going to Rome.
Amen.
My promise is you're going to Rome. Sometimes we need to just practice the presence of God. Amen. We need to understand the precepts of God. Amen. We need the praise from God, the pat on the back. Amen. That he sees us being faithful even when it's not manning up to what we want it to be. And then the promise of God. You're going to bear witness also at Rome. Listen, Paul, I'm not done with you. This isn't the end. But I have bigger, better plans for you. You know what? God is not done with our life. Amen. It's not over until we've drawn our final breath. And who knows what God can do even in those final moments. I don't feel like any of us are there yet, or doesn't look displayed that you're there yet. So I just want to say that God has plans for you. I believe, Brother David, you said it well, restore the new again. Sometimes we need that new again. That restoration, that renewal, that reviving that only the Spirit of God can do. Revive us again, oh Lord. This isn't the end. What do you have in the future? What's your plans for me? God, I know that you have something. Amen. Man may not want you, Paul, but God wants you. Listen, you may feel like you're wore out and you're wore down and you've been rejected. It doesn't matter. Amen. God still wants you and God still has plans for you.
Amen.
Joseph, God's not done. This morning I preached on Samuel and we looked at him in his youth, but if I could hit fast forward and come to the end of his life, Brother Dennis, I look at his life and I see where the nation of Israel, Brother Justin, was so done with Samuel, but God wasn't. And they wanted a king, Sister Tina. Give us a king as all the others. But God wasn't done with Samuel. It wasn't God's plan. God gave them what they wanted. So what's Samuel going to do, Brother Doug? He's been rejected by the nation of Israel. I'll tell you what he's going to do. He's still going to be faithful. He's still going to be a voice of truth. Truth, even when a king rises up and his heart strays away from God, he's still going to be truth. Amen. Oh, and there's a young lad that needs to be anointed. Brother Dennis, he's still going to be there to anoint, because God's not done with him. God's not done with you. God has things for your life. No matter what the past has been, how great or how poor in your opinion, God still has plans for you. I look at the life of Samson. I looked at Samuel and Samson, compared their lives in the beginning of my message this morning. But Brother David, even as different and diverse as Samson was from Samuel, and as far as his heart was away from God, Brother Justin, God wasn't done with him. Even in his death, God did great things. God's not through. I look and I think about Peter, even when he denied Christ, God wasn't done with him. I look at a man, as I said this morning, in Motel Whale, but God wasn't done with Jonah. God had a plan. And so it's hearing the promises of God. How do we stay encouraged? How do we live victorious? The presence of God. The presence of God. And when you need encouragement, get in the presence of God. Because God will come and visit you. Get the precepts from God. Stop just wanting the promises. But hear the commands of God and do them. The praise from God. Forget about what man says. Forget about what others says. And let God say, you've done what I have asked. And that's what matters. And then hear the promise of God. I still have. Amen. Sister Beth, if you come to the piano tonight, that's the word that God has laid on my heart. So wherever you're at, if you're discouraged tonight, there's encouragement. If you're wanting to maintain encouragement tonight, this is how we do it. Amen. By practicing the presence of God. Getting the precepts of God. We have to do it God's way. What does God say? Brother George, I want to hear God. I want His hoarse promises. But whatever God says, do. I want to do. Whether it's in the written word of God, Sister Dietrich, or whether it's by the moving of the Spirit of God, I want to make sure I'm obedient. Following the precepts of God. If you feel like you're a failure, but you've tried to do it God's way, get in a place where God can come by, give you that power back. But you've done it my way. Forget about what everyone else says. You've done what I've asked. Or if you're wondering where to go, the direction, tonight it's time to grab hold of the promise of God that He has things for you. Wherever you're at tonight, be encouraged, sing of God. God wants to work for you. Would you gather and find a place of prayer this evening?
Hallelujah.